Game on!
This man, the power, has done it all and will continue to win huge events. You're seeing Phil Taylor's new darts, unveiled last week. He's been using them for a couple of months now, practicing with them, but there's nothing like the pressure of a big match to find out how they go. It's okay practicing it in nine darters, which he's been doing. But as soon as the pressure's on, the hand reacts in different ways and your release changes.
Well, it's not quite like a golfer changing clubs. It's not that dramatic a switch. He's often said when asked, give me half an hour and I can throw any dart to a very, very high degree of accuracy. But as you say, Wayne, to play first up in your first competitive match against the world champ with new equipment, it's a question mark.
It is, yeah. You miss one or two darts at double, or throw one or two shoddy darts at 60. Phil Taylor has not hit the ground running. Michael van Gerwen could nick this leg and break with a mediocre effort.
I thought it was interesting what Dave Clark was saying just prior to the match starting, that Phil Taylor had tapped him on the shoulder and said, look, I've done everything right in the build-up, I've prepared absolutely properly, which you'd expect him to. But if he has done all that and he still gets beat, where does that leave Phil Taylor?
98.
You've probably noticed that Phil as well is looking very svelte. Just a hell of a lot of weight within 6-7 weeks. A change of diet, a new fitness regime, new darts, and a new world ranking, which is world rank number two, because Michael van Gerwen is the world number one. The power will not like that. Poor start from Phil Taylor.
100.
Well, last seen on our screens, being ousted unexpectedly from the World Championship by Michael Smith some 7 weeks ago.
95.
And Gerwen has been involved still in competitive play. As, all right, he didn't win last weekend, but he was competing, match 60. Practice, match play.
Michael van Gerwen just loves playing, and why not? He's a 24-year-old with the darting world at his fingertips. And he just wants, like you said, he just wants to compete. Surely!
140.
Well, apparently not.
Taylor looking lean, van Gerwen looking mean, taking the first leg against the darts.
Last year, these two played each other 11 times, 5 wins each and a draw. Take from that what you want, but certainly no one. Taylor doesn't dominate. Van Gerwen doesn't dominate Taylor.
Well, new darts or not, he still doesn't like the lie above the treble bed. And that's why he's having to go around Charlie chasing trebles all around the board. 21. Finding none of them. Treble 17, his ball. Middle of the board.
The
for a 1-2-1 check and a 2-0 lead.
Phil will be thinking, okay, it was your throw. 1-2-1 donut. This is a huge leg for Phil Taylor.
96.
He's not playing well.
57.
Well, that's a bit of a let off.
Well, rivals have come and rivals have gone over two darting decades for Phil Taylor. Priestley, Park. Very briefly, Mardle. King, Wade, Van Barneveld, and now Van Gerwen. But somebody is going to be the man that finally knocks him off the perch. But at the moment, looks like it could be this man.
Yeah, Barney mentioned in his interview, didn't he, about Phil Taylor. How he would respond to not being a world champ and using new darts. Well, averaging 95.
86.
92 now. That is not going to wash against the green machine.
The facial contortions of the great Michael van Gerning, delighting his legion of fans that have crammed into the Echo Arena at the moment. He's giving the great man, the 16 times world champ, something of a toweling early on in the piece.
57. Michael Rapal, 124.
1-2-1 in the previous leg. Doesn't even have to go for the ball route.
92.
On the Taylor throw, Van Gerwen can just set it up. Phil Taylor averaging 89. Now, is it the darts or has he lost his confidence? Or is it both?
135. Michael Rapal, 32.
2-16s to go, 3-0.
In shot on the third line.
It's confident, it's clean, it's clinical. With the class of a world champion.
Well, this is how good Michael van Gerwen is. Raymond van Barneveld averaged 108.52 and seemed to be missing nothing. Michael van Gerwen is just playing. He doesn't seem to be doing anything special and averaging 109.30.
114.
Well, the last televised tussle was the final of the Players' Championships, just before the World Championship, and Taylor
99.
Looked like he was coasting to a win over Van Gerwen. He led 6-3 when suddenly MVG reeled off a nigh-on-perfect run of seven legs of darts, in which Taylor didn't get a sniff at a double. And I think that really wounded him, hurt him. He was perplexed, confused and bemused, wasn't he? And it carried on into the World Championship.
Well,
Michael Van Gerwen stood up to him, didn't he? It was someone saying, look, you can do what you like, mate. I'm going to stand up to you. But Phil's improved over the last leg and a bit. That is three 140s on the bounce. That'll make him feel better.
Make him feel even better if he takes the 81 out. And, you know, he's throwing some awful stuff early on, but he's now averaging more than 100. Now, this is a potential game changer. Yes, superb first dart. Double 12. This for a dozen dart leg.
69.
But he can't clean it up.
The last dart was weak. That needed to be high. That leaves double 8 for 4-0. Phil Taylor
line.
Misses. Michael van Gerwen doesn't. It equates to 4-0. Taylor is being taught a lesson by Michael van Gerwen. Don't miss your opportunities.
Well, he's being Taylorized. This is exactly what Phil Taylor did to opponent after opponent, wasn't it?
Decade after decade.
You miss, bang, I'll go out. And I'll keep doing it till the game finishes.
And the important thing from Michael's point of view is that Phil Taylor knows that Michael's not just going to run out of steam or go off the boil. He knows that MVG is the real deal.
58.
Unlike Taylor, normally brilliant on the cover shooting.
Worrying times for Phil Taylor and his fans. He's had bad starts to Premier Leagues before, hasn't he? When he stuttered and stumbled, and in fact he lost four games in the Premier League
58.
Last year and still got within a couple of legs of winning the final, so unwise to write the power off, but
140.
This is a tough night at the office.
Yeah, this is playing Michael van Gerwen at his very best, though. For Phil Taylor to even consider that he would carry on playing this poorly, he's averaging 96, but this isn't Taylor-esque.
Michael require 81.
To even consider that he wouldn't be in the playoffs is unimaginable. 32.
Game
no bother.
Michael van Gerwen.
Five starts at a double. Five successful hits. Michael van Gerwen averaging 112. Five love.
140.
Well, they met on opening night last year in Belfast. Van Gerwen should have won. He missed match darts. It was a draw.
83.
Well, dare I suggest it, Wayne, to a man who's been on the wrong end of a whitewash of Phil Taylor, is it remotely possible that Phil Taylor could lose a match 7-0?
I would always say no. But, my God, no, yes, it is possible. Of course it is now, but the thing is that Michael... I don't think he'd get carried away with the scoreline. He's knowledgeable enough to know that even if he does go and whitewash Phil Taylor, that Phil will be back and Phil will inflict pain on other players. That's what Phil Taylor does. As you said, Rod, this is one bad day at the office so far. 100. Not finished yet.
Well, he leaves a three-out combination. But the problem is, Michael van Gerwen is leaving a single darter.
The pressure on Phil Taylor now is immense. Treble 18. Well, that is just poor. That's a real poor dart. He will be disgusted with himself. For 6-0.
Michael van Gerwen leads Phil Taylor, 16-chance world champion, 6-0. And if Phil Taylor fails to hold throw here, he will be whitewashed.
The pressure is immense now. It really is on Phil Taylor. I've been in this situation against Phil Taylor. 96. And you're thinking, right, come on. Just don't throw wayward darts. Hit tons, hit 140s, 180s. Don't give your opponent a chance to whitewash me. But when you're playing MVG, averaging 113.79, look at the loudometer!
Well, it's the panicometer here for Phil Taylor. Look, no one wants to see great champions battered and bruised on the big stage. It's
96.
In any sport, but Michael van Gerwen will be remorseless and ruthless.
Has to hit another treble. Well, 84. The second and third darts were not thrown confidently, were they? A big score here, 7-0, is likely. May go bullseye, or may go treble 15. 65.
Well, this is a great visit.
133.
And that may be enough to avoid the whitewash. It'll certainly be enough to get him two darts and a double to avoid the whitewash.
Yeah, it was a magnificent shot from Phil. 16 double. 8 for Tops to get his first leg on the board. That was weak. Double 10.
48. Michael
Van Gerwen 16. For a whitewash. An incredible whitewash. Michael van Gerwen wants double 10. And the man who for two decades handed out the hammerings has been hammered. Whitewashed on the big stage, and the world champion shows who's boss on opening night in the Premier League. Phil Taylor humbled 7-0 by MVG.